Gentleman yields back. The gentleman from Virginia reserves. The gentleman from New York is recognized.
Mr. Speaker, I now yield 3 minutes to the gentleman from Maryland, Mr. Delaney.
The gentleman from Maryland is recognized for 3 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise in strong opposition to the ballot budget amendment, which, in my judgment, is one of the worst pieces of legislation I have seen since I've been in the Congress. First, it will act as a doomsday machine, destroying critical programs like Social Security, Medicare, investments in our infrastructure, investments in science and research, investments in our military. Secondly, it represents wrong-headed economics. To manage the country with a zero deficit is not smart economic policy. Thirdly, it's being presented to the American people in a deceitful manner. To compare fiscal planning of the U.S. government to how hardworking families in this country should manage their own personal finances is misrepresenting how we should think about our government. And fourth, it's being done entirely for political reasons, to direct attention away from tax legislation that has materially increased the deficit of this country. If we wanted to have an honest conversation about the fiscal situation of this country, which is terrible and projected to be worse, we would focus on three numbers. The first number we'd focus on, or the first percentage, is our debt as a percentage of our economy. The second ratio we'd focus on is how much we think our economy could grow each year. And the third number we would focus on is the percentage of our deficit as expressed relative to our economy. If we actually wanted to work together, if the majority and the minority wanted to work together and put together a fiscal plan for this country that was responsible, that represented smart economics, allowed us to invest in our country, and put us on a trajectory where the debt as a percentage of our economy would go down over time and return to normal levels, then we would be talking about how do we come up with a budget that had deficits on an annual basis of -1.5% to 2%. That wouldn't put us in a position where we have to slash so many important government programs because this government has insufficient tax revenues. In fact, our tax revenues are the lowest as a percentage of our economy that they've been in 50 years. But if we actually wanted to have a real conversation about putting this country on an appropriate kind of long-term fiscal trajectory, we would work towards 2% deficits. Because if, in fact, our economy could grow at 2.5% a year, then by definition, the debt as a percentage of our economy would go down. And it would go down by setting realistic goals that don't represent inappropriate cuts to core government programs like Medicare and Social Security and our defense spending and our investment in our country and our kids and our infrastructure and our research. That would be a conversation that represents smart economic policy. It would be an honest conversation with the American people. It wouldn't be done for political reasons, and it would materially improve the fiscal trajectory of this country. I yield back.
The gentleman yields back. The gentleman from New York reserves. The gentleman from Virginia is recognized.